Hello to all lovers of Creative Ends platform. You are welcome to today's video on how to make the applique hand fan. Today I will be making a love shape applique hand fan. I started this pattern by fusing my organzas together, so I'll show you a little video of how I did that. I use my stoning machine, or heat transfer machine as it's popularly called, to fuse my organza in three layers together. So I use the stoning machine to fuse my organza in three layers together. So what I did was that I used felt on it. I started by spreading out the first layer using felt to cover. After that, I cover it with another organza, and again I spread it out a second time, and then I use felt again to cover. The purpose or reason why I have to do this is because I want it to be very thick. I don't want it to be too light. When it's too light, it's not going to come out very well for your work, and you don't want that to happen. So after achieving that, I cut out the pattern like you saw in the beginning, and after cutting out the pattern, I used my glitter to go through the shape so that the art design can come out and be reflective. After that, I covered my hand fan skeleton with same color of organza, and after that I started applying the art shape to the hand fan skeleton. While you try to place it, you really have to be a little bit careful so that you don't lose your design, because placing this art shape seems a little bit more difficult than I thought. Because while I was doing the work, I discovered that placing it wasn't just as easy as placing an ordinary circle or placing a V, you know, the triangular shape pattern. It wasn't as easy as that, because you just have to work it out such that the art has to, let me use the word, align. That is, they have to align to each other. So it's not something you carelessly place. You place it with the consciousness that you don't want to lose the look or the shape of how it originally ought to look like. So what I'm trying to say in essence is that your placement requires a little bit of care. You know that once the shape is stick to the skeleton, it becomes a little bit difficult for you to pull out, and anything that makes you try to force it and pull it out is going to make your work rough, and I would like that you avoid such. So one other thing I want to advise is that while you place, if you want it to be bigger and contain more of this your shape, you have to use the method of cutting off the back. That is, with the part where I am adding glue now, that is sharp like triangle, you cut it off. When you cut it off, you will now have a flat base for it to sit, instead of this narrow V part. In short, when you fix it like this, it looks more confusing. But if you cut out that part, it will sit better, especially for beginners. That's why I'm explaining this, all right? And then if you can actually be calculative and fix it like this, you might even do without using extra embellishment, because you see that the edge has a smooth flow. It has a smooth flow, yes. So you might even just do without embellishment. So that is one advantage of fixing it like this, because it actually came out very well. It came out in a beautiful wavy flow, and me, I love it, all right? So it is one advantage of doing it like this, but if you feel you cannot be careful enough to do it like this, please cut the button, cut it off, cut off that V part out of it so that it can sit flat without any form of contention, and you will get the best result if you do it like that. So after fixing this part, I went ahead to fix the back, also cover the back, then cover with embellishment, and then added stone. It came out very well from my own judgment. You know, everybody, they say beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. From my own eyes, it came out very well, the way I really want it to look. You know, I want something different, not just different, unique, not just unique, attractive, you know. And I got what I actually wanted, and the result was a superb one. And I do hope that you also admire the finishing result, all right, because I do. So if today is your first time joining me, please do well to subscribe to our channel today. Yes, do well to subscribe so that you can become part of our community, the community of creative ends, people that are creating things, you know, innovators. So you can become part of us. Please do not forget to join us today. Hit on the notification bell. It will help you to get notified whenever we put up new videos. You'll be among the first people to see, first to comment, first to ask questions, you know. You will even be among the first people to try it out, all right, because in this place we are creative. We come up with things, we don't copy and paste, we do our own things, and you will love it. So please join us. Thank you very much. I love you. Bye. Be the best that you could be, and the Lord will do the rest. Do your best and leave the rest. God bless you. Bye.